Good morning, students. In this video, let us find the Fourier transform of an impulse function or a Dirac delta function. Let us find the Fourier transform of this del of t, and del of t we know that it is equal to infinity for t is equal to 0. It is equal to 0 if t not equal to 0. This is the definition of del of t. And Fourier transform of a signal x of t, if we consider x of omega, and here x of omega is minus infinity to plus infinity, x of t e power minus j omega t dt. This is the formula for Fourier transform. Now let us substitute x of t is del of t here. So minus infinity to plus infinity, del of t e power minus j omega t dt. Now we have to simplify this expression. So for simplifying this expression, let us consider the shifting property of the impulse function. All the properties of the impulse function I have given in the basic elementary signal videos. So from that shifting property, I am rewriting here the shifting property of delta function. What it is? It is minus infinity to plus infinity del of t, if it is multiplied with a function f of t, that should be equal to f of 0. Comparing this shifting property with this expression, here f of t is nothing but e to the power of j omega t, minus j omega t. Then what is f of 0 means? E to the power of 0 is the final value after simplifying this expression according to the shifting property of the unit impulse function. So that it is e to the power of 0, that is 1. So the Fourier transform of delta function is equal to 1, and we can recall that the Laplace transform of delta function is equal to 1, and the Z transform of the delta function, a discrete version, is also 1. This is the only signal for which Fourier transform, Laplace transform, Z transform, three transforms are equal. Right. Fine, thank you.